Danielson.
Welcome, Danielson.
Warren.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So glad
Hi, I'm Mark Kohler. Nice to meet you.
I'm Leslie Stevens.
And good morning, Miss.
Good morning. We're glad you're here today.
I'm looking forward to this visit. Let's go.
You want to go check out the classrooms?
Yes.
Yeah, let's go.
All right, Mark, so what's happening over here?
Stand-up math is what's happening. Actually, this is Ms. Hunt's sixth grade math class, and what you see happening is something called vertical non-permanent surfaces. And so our sixth grade math teachers, actually our entire math department, did a book study up this summer about the thinking classroom and building the thinking classroom. And so one of the things that they learned was you got to get kids up, you got to get oxygen flowing in their brain, and you got to get them manipulating math and working through the problems before you sit them down and give them the notes.
And then so 0.15,
and then we show up,
and then -1.
What are we doing today?
So today they're graphing with rational numbers. So they have a little bit of prior knowledge with graphing, but just with integers. And so they have four different tasks, all at different levels, that will kind of build up to our end goal for the lesson.
So Jack, you told me you took theater arts. Tell me about the program.
I did, mostly a hockey player, but I did take theater. We actually won our UIL one-act play for our region last year, and this year our new theater teacher, Ms. Stofko, is doing great. We have over 70 kids trying out for the UIL one-act play and 40 trying out for the monologue.
Good morning, Kate.
Good morning.
Can you tell us what's going on in the theater classroom today?
Yes. So this week they are working on commercials and advertising, and they have to be in groups, and they're going to be choosing a product and then writing a script and creating a commercial and then creating a billboard for that product on Canva.
All in 1 week?
All in 1 week. So it is due on Wednesday, so I hope they get it done.
So Akbar, what product are you working on?
Well, we are building a new iPhone, but we're also making it very funny. So it's going to be like iPhone 30 Pro Max.
What aspect of this whole project do you like the best?
I like the commercial because it's fun. It's like we get to work together as a group.
All right, so we're experiencing a middle school passing period. Boys, can you tell me, what is it like to be in middle school, and what's a middle school passing period like?
It's definitely a lot of kids trying to go to all different places, and it helps to be an eighth grader because you're typically taller and people kind of like part ways for the tall people.
So I've noticed that you teach fundamentals of computer science. What do you do in that class?
So it's kind of the first taste of computer science for middle schoolers. It's a high school credit, and we do a little bit of everything. We do web page design. We do app creation. We'll end up creating a video game. So there's a little bit of something. About every 6 weeks, we kind of switch topics.
We're just wrapping up our HTML unit now.
Speaking of computer science, in your fifth period, you have two students that go by the name of DJ and Jack. What's your opinion on those two?
I mean, you know, anyone can do a little bit better, but they're really good students.
So I do see that floor plan over there that shows classroom, makerspace, and multipurpose. How is this space being used?
We converted this room to a makerspace and gateway classroom. So we have some tools in here that like a regular gateway classroom wouldn't have. We have a poster printer, we have extra 3D printers. We have a CNC machine. It takes a block of whatever material we put in there and we can actually carve out the figures that they create.
It's like a reverse 3D printer.
Mm-hmm, exactly.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thanks for showing me around your beautiful school, and I enjoyed seeing the student learning in action. Bear down.
Go Cats!